So in January of this year, you became CEO of this company. Congratulations.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
So what became important to you once you began the role?
The key objective of me taking the CEO job was to return this company to growth. The company had not been growing for the last 10 years, neither top line, neither bottom line. And so the main driver was to say, we can get this company back to growth, potentially, by really changing the culture from a silo, a bit of fear culture, risk avoidance culture, to a culture that would be much more collaborative culture, much more transparent, much more working together. And if we could do that shift, I was convinced that we could really get much more results. And so we came with a plan that we called Fit for Growth, encompassing, of course, the growth element, but also the fit elements, and saying we need to invest more in our infrastructures, in our network, in our solution, but we also need to transform the company to make sure that we can unleash this growth. And the transformation, of course, you had some elements which are transformational elements, like simplifying the organization, becoming more efficient, going from two brands to one brand to have all the products on one brand, making sure that we put the customer in front of everything we do. But to make sure that that is possible, what made the difference was the good to gold culture. This was really the glue that enabled us to bring all these transformational elements together. And so the culture needs then to become real changes in attitudes of the people. And that's the key, because in the end, it's not the management team that makes the difference. They can be a role model, or you talk about the shadow of the leader, they probably have a big shadow. But what makes a difference, if the people believe in a new story, change the way they behave, and that our customers experience a different company, a different interaction. And I think that's what's starting now to come true, because probably in the beginning, I was the only one to believe we could grow again.
So you've mentioned how the good to gold culture is at the heart of your Fit for Growth strategy. So would you just talk a little bit about that strategy and why good to gold is such an important part of it?
The Fit for Growth strategy is all about how can we return the company to growth, making sure that we have enough money to invest in our networks, in new solutions, new services, but also a big part around transformation. Transformation is built around four blocks, which is how can we make sure that we are really customer-centric and we put the customer at the center of everything we do? How we make sure that we have stronger brands and a much clearer proposition for the customers in how we express ourselves to the external market? But also, how do we make sure we get to a more agile and efficient organization? And how do we simplify the business we work in? And to make sure that all these pieces can hold together, the good-to-gold culture is really essential, because it's people need to understand that they can really work and help each of these dimensions if they do it the right way with the right culture.
And so what benefits have you seen over time since we began in the good-to-gold process?
A lot, but you need to take the time. It's a journey. And so the first part of this journey is at the managed, is the executive team level. So trying to make from a bunch of individuals a team was quite a challenge. Getting to know each other better, getting to trust each other, trying to define a common vision, a common strategy that was shared by all of us and transparently communicated to the rest of the company. It was not an easy process, but when you then get there, it's really powerful.
So talk us through how the whole company became involved.
So it was first about the executive team sharing a certain number of statements that we wanted to say, saying that we, for instance, one of them was, we want to be successful as a team, which was very, it's very basics when you say it like that, but for the company, it was something very different from what we experienced before. So that was one, for instance. Another one was, we will make sure that we give coaching and feedback to the people, that we are transparent in how we say things, and that we favor reward and recognition. Also something that normally you find as very basic, but when you engage as executive team to do that, of course, that can change things. So first thing is that agree within ourselves to do that, express it, and then show it. So when people then come to the executive committee, make sure that what you have said is translated into your attitude, into the way you interact with the people. And then it starts. And of course, what's important then is that you engage the whole leadership team or the extended leadership team. So they went through indeed the good to gold or Senn Delaney process with unfreezing session, reinforcement session, making sure that we could help them understand where do we want to go, why do we do this, and what is their role in that whole process about culture shaping. So that was the first part of it. Afterward, we said we cannot stop at the leadership team. We're talking about 170 people out of the 14,000 of the company. And today, we are, I think, 2 years down the process. We have now more than 2,200 team leaders that have gone through the unfreezing and almost all of them reinforcement session. And you really see the new culture really spreading into the organization. And that's great. In the meantime, we have been able to show that growth was possible. Our last results were already giving some growth in our two main businesses. And in the end, we are not doing things that are very different from our competitors. So we're investing more, we're transforming, we're cutting costs, we want. But why are we successful so far while others are not? I think it's about the soft issue. It's about changing the mindset of the people. It's about engaging the people in the story, making them believe that you can make the difference, making them go the extra mile, changing their attitude and their behavior.
Talk us a little bit about how Good to Gold has shifted and adapted to support your growth agenda and has enabled you to carry on this story of growth.
It was very much about making sure that you could bring people to work together. And so we went with Senn Delaney to a process on what are, for instance, the three values that are the key ones to lead the change. And so we came with three values, which was agility, collaboration, and accountability. Of course, when you say it like that, it can sound obvious, but the process to get there is very important because it makes people think about what are the elements that will make us more successful tomorrow. And if as a team you can come to these values and you can show it every day in how you behave, certainly as a leader of the company, it really starts to change the way people work together and it unleashes a lot of power. I can give some example. For instance, this company has tried to reduce costs already for many years, not very successfully. And I probably think thanks to these values and the fact that I said to the people, I don't want to know about FTEs, for instance, but what's important is that next year we can reduce the cost structure. How you do it, you try to do it by yourself. And to be honest, where in the past we had very hard target on FTE reduction that we could never hit, today I have no target on FTE reduction, but I'm much lower on FTE that we have never been in the company.
Why do you think that change has happened then?
I think it's about people being accountable and being able to make the choices that they think are the best one for the company. It's about giving them the freedom to say, if you need people on certain area, because there it's where you grow, you can hire them. But you need to make sure that overall, your cost structure goes down.
And people have done that without being told.
Yes, it was amazing because it all came through without even us asking for it. And we got even further down in terms of cost reduction that we had hoped in the beginning of the year. Because people took it on board and realized it. Probably another example is in telecommunication business, what's very important is how you invest your money. We spend around 1 billion euro every year in capital expenditure, in investments. And there in the past, it was very much micromanaged, a lot of small pieces. And in the end, of course, there was never enough budget for all the priorities. So we changed there again the way of working and we said we will define 8 blue chips. And we say, these are our key priorities for the company. And so we have then put all our investments in these 8 clusters. And we have said to a team, you are now responsible to find together what are the key investments you need to do to get to this objective.
But what were people's reactions when you first made that decision?
They called it the Black Tuesday. The day we decided to do that was seen by some people as the Black Tuesday because it was a bit of a revolution. Mm-hmm. It was about giving much bigger power to some team, but also pushing people to work together. But as in every change, the first moment is a very, is tough. And when you force people through the change and they see that there are good results coming out of it and they know much better each other, they know more about the business, they are more accountable, you reach a fantastic result.
What's been the biggest challenge for you and your BMC leadership team?
To keep faith in the end goal. To make sure that we continue to behave as role model, because you have tensions, and when you have tensions or conflicts, you tend to come back in old habits. So very important. And I think there, what I would like to say is that the process of the Senn Delaney with the concept, where you have a name on the concept, is extremely powerful. Because when in a meeting, you see people drifting away from the desired behavior, there is a way to get them back to the right behavior by just saying, be here now, or watch your mood lift, or think of the shadow of the leader, which are concepts. Then when you say them, they are not hurting anyone, but brings the person very much back in. So for me, one of the key value of this culture shaping process is the fact that you have real concepts based on insight that you first need to discover for yourself, understand, but that afterwards you can use in a team context and bringing them just into the room, make sure that everyone again is back with the right value. So it's very powerful.
So what are some of the things that have come to pass recently that are successes for you?
It's very important that you can translate the culture you are shaping into business successes, because that's the way most of the people then will start following you. And that's something I've discovered now after the third quarter results, which were good, and we had some good new customers, engagements, things like that. You really see the dynamic changing in the company because it becomes, for most of the people, concrete, anchored in the success of the company.
And of course, you've achieved your goal of growth 12 months early.
Yeah, that's probably more an issue than a success, I would say, because it puts a lot of pressure on the management to go further. I think we are together on a journey. So for me, it's important also to keep managing expectations, certainly of the outside world, and making sure that even if you have early success, you don't destroy everything by moving the bar up too fast.
What are some of the lessons you've learned, and what advice would you give to both leaders and also CEOs who are contemplating this kind of process?
It's not about what you do. It's not about what you try to achieve. It's all about how you do it. And I think on the how, the culture and the way people work together is extremely important. And if you can create that culture where people trust each other, build on each other, unleash the energy, what I call growth mindsets, this is a concept I like very much, is we need to bring growth company, growth mindset, continuously develop people. And if you get your people in that positive spiral, I think you can achieve much more than the others, and that will make you more successful than your competitor.
Belgcacom has a purpose that we worked on some time ago, which is around using devices to connect people to their world. So talk a little bit about how that was a foundation point for the rebranding of the company.
Yeah, I think that's very important, because when you then have a purpose, a mission, it's important that everybody understands it. And so in that sense, when we did the rebranding of our two brands, Belgacom Proximus to a new Proximus, it was very important for us to say, how will we position these brands? We want to bring people close to what matters so they can live better and they can work smarter. And so in that sense, we try to translate it in our brands, but also in all our innovation program and our customer experience enhancement program we have, we look at that. How are we able to bring new solutions that are easy to work with, that are enabling people to connect to the world they like and make their life easier? or make their work smarter, more efficient. And it's now becoming, I would say, a check on everything we do.
And what role does the culture play in reinforcing that brand promise?
I think the culture is key, because if you don't have this why and this mission very much present, you go back into the old habits of doing all your nitty-gritty, and it doesn't fit together. I think having the culture with collaboration, agility, accountability as key values, together with a clear purpose, helps really people to make the right trade-offs on a collective basis. So you don't even need to express it all the time. It's part of the way you make decisions.
Is there a piece of advice you would have for somebody who's contemplating starting on this journey you talked about?
It's a journey, so it's a long journey. So be prepared to go into that journey, but to take the necessary time. And certainly if you are the CEO, lead it. It's very important. You always underestimate the shadow of the leader.
It's been a pleasure talking to you. And it's been great to hear those stories of success from good to gold. So thank you very much.
Thank you to you too. Thank you.